The passage of a Senate bill seeking to revive the Mandatory Reserve Officers Training Corps, or ROTC, eyed this year. Sherry Ann Torres reports.
Bahagi po ng pagiging isang magulang ang ituro sa kanyang mga anak kung paano ipagtanggol ang sarili mula sa anumang mga banta na maari niyang kaharapin.
Senator Ronald De La Rosa was able to sponsor the proposed return of the Reserve Officers Training Corps, or ROTC, program before both houses of Congress marked its Holy Week break. The ROTC Act, contained in Committee Report 62, signed by 15 senators, mandates all college and vocational students, male and female, and even foreigners to take the program or they cannot graduate.
No exemption. Kagaya ng mga foreigners, you cannot subject them to yung to love our country, to die for our country because they belong to another country. And yet, hindi pa sila accepted sa ROTC, they will undergo a ROTC program with different program of instruction.
The program will provide physical military training as well as education about disaster response, environmental protection, intellectual and personality development, patriotism, and nationalism. The Department of National Defense, meanwhile, will allot 5 billion pesos for the free military uniform and combat boots of all ROTC trainees. De La Rosa rules out possible abuses in this program with the creation of a grievance committee in all schools to be monitored by the National Grievance and Monitoring Council.
Ako personally, mag-monitor talaga ako niyan dahil gagawin naman nila yan. Baka mamaya darating ang araw na sabihin na yung anak ko namatay sa hising sa ROTC dahil sa bato ROTC law. So hindi ko matanggap-tanggap yang ganyan na ganun ako ano, mahirap konsensya mo rin yan, no? Kaya siguruhin natin na maganda ang pagka-implementa nito.
Still, Senate Minority Leader Aquilino Pimentel III could not understand the wisdom behind the inclusion of foreigners in the ROTC mandatory program. Much more, training foreigners using Filipino taxpayers' money. Students' reactions are mixed.
Okay naman po siya in a way na parang natutulungan po tayong maging aware sa nangyayari sa paligid, maging socially aware. Pero syempre, meron din po siyang disadvantages, lalo na if biglaan po siyang i-implement.
Sa akin, maganda siya kasi magkakaroon tayo ng karagdagang kaalaman at saka matututo tayong depensa ng mga sarili natin. Pero andun yung takot ng mga kababaihan, kalalakihan, kasi during training may part na baka maabuso tayo habang nagtitraining.
Pero po siguro hindi po ngayon siguro yung right time para po ipatupad ito kasi mas marami pa po tayong need na i-prioritize, lalo po sa education system natin ngayon, lalo nga po na nag-pandemic. Yung mga pang-aabuso po hindi po siya malabong mangyari.
De La Rosa targets to have the ROTC bill passed into law within the year. Next to his sponsorship speech in the Senate will be the debate and period of amendments. Sherry Ann Torres, ABS-CBN News.
The Philippine Interior Secretary alleges a high-level police cover-up in the drug trafficking case of dismissed police master Sergeant Rodolfo Mayo Jr. This as he expressed disappointment over the slow progress of the investigation. Mayo was formerly with the Police Drug Enforcement Group. He was arrested in October last year during a drug buy bust in Manila, which yielded 6.7 billion pesos worth of shabu. He was dismissed last month. Interior Secretary Benhur Abalos has directed 10 senior police officers allegedly involved in the cover-up to file their leave this week or face suspension.
Mag-leave na lang muna sila pending investigation. If not, they will be suspended pending investigation. Hindi kami papayag na masira ang ating bansa nitong droga. Kung kailangan linisin ang rango, gagawin namin ang sinumpaan namin dito.
Maya's arrest prompted Abalos back in January to call on all police colonels and generals to submit their courtesy resignations as a special panel looks into their possible links to the illegal drug trade.